Hello, today I would like to show the way how I am going to replace front suspension on my 2006 Nissan Xterra. And in front of camera you can see all main components for driver side. I am going to replace wheel hub bearing, brake rotors and brake pads, upper control arm, stabilizer bar bushings, lower control arm, inner tie rod and front shock. And mounting bolts for upper control arm, they wasn't included. I get those from dealership. And it's M14, thread size 1.5 and length is 80 millimeters. So you have two per side. And for a lower control arm, I was using camber bolts, so it's also two per each side. I'm also going to replace axle nut, and control arms. I choose to have a greasable one, so. They come with this fitting, which gonna allow to have to pump grease on them. Same for a lower control arm. It also has this insert, as well as camber bolts. They also gonna be greasable with tiny inserts. And this bolt, it was provided on the kit. It's gonna hold lower ball joint. For removing inner tie rod, I was using this type of tool, and same tool I was using for installing new tie rod. For removing axle nut, I was using 32 mm deep socket. For removing lower control arm, I was using this type of saw. Because old camber bolts, they was seized, and I wasn't be able to remove them in normal way. So I cut them off. I used these blades. I already replaced passenger side, and it has a lot of components which had to have special torque. So I tied all of them in the end, and what I did, I after each tightness I put marks, so that in this way I know for sure that I haven't missed any of untightened bolts or nuts. In this project I'm going to use impact wrench. So, but in case if I would use just regular breaker bars to work on steering components like axle nut, I would use this 2x4 piece. I would apply it to a brake to prevent it from spinning. So I would just use it in this way. I would apply it to wheel, and to play with lengths I would use just regular journals between it to make proper lengths and proper power for brakes. And I already lifted up front of the vehicle, and at this time I'm going to remove front wheel. I'm going to use this 21 deep socket. Right now I'm gonna remove this 1.5 inch spacer with 19 mm socket. This time I'm gonna remove brake caliper. I'm gonna start removing this brake caliper and this metal wire. I'm gonna hook it to this location. And right now I'm just gonna remove this bracket, this caliper bracket, and for this purpose I keep key inside of engine, which allowed me to have freely spin of a steering. I'm gonna keep it on side. And at this moment I'm just gonna spray this penetrating fluid or axle nut. I'm gonna apply a big amount of penetrating fluid. And at this moment I'm going to remove this ABS sensor. I'm gonna try to use this type of pliers to disconnect it, but before it I'm just going to remove it from housing which located on the frame. So I'm just gonna lift it up. I lift it up. So, and now I'm going to use pliers. Yeah, it's good, it's done. So what I did, I just pressed this button which is located on top of it. I try to press it and only after I pull it out. And at next moment I'm just gonna remove it from housings, from all four locations. So all of these locations, I'm gonna remove it. If it's not removing, I'm going to use some penetrating fluid. On my next move, I'm going to lose this nut, and for this purpose, I'm gonna use this type of wrench. I loosened it up, but I'm not gonna remove it completely. I'm gonna tighten it up back to the same position to count threads, so that it would not going to be very big off for alignment. And right now I'm going to loosen up this bolt joint. I'm going to use 22mm socket. And right now I'm going to put same penetrating coil inside. And after I'm going to put this nut upside down to have flat part on the top. Yeah, it's good. It works. I'm happy. So I'm gonna keep it on the side. So sometimes it's better to give some time for penetrating coil to start working. At this moment, I'm going to start counting threads inside, so I'm gonna release it from this end. And right now I'm going to count amount of threads. Thirteen and a half. And right now I'm going to remove stabilizer link. It's two bolts, they're 18 millimeter. And after I'm going to, before removing it from these connections, I'm going to disconnect bracket for sway bar. And that supposed to be two bolts, they're 17 millimeter. Just long one, long socket. I will keep it on the side. I'm just gonna take it from links. I will remove upper shock bolts. It's three of them, and they're 14 millimeter. And I also sprayed penetrating fluid before. Location for those mount bolts is over here. And one piece is on the farther side. So, three bolts. And after I'm going to remove lower mounting bolt from shock. I'm going to remove this lower mounting bolt, and for this purpose I'm using 19 millimeter wrench from one side, and from other side I'm using this 22 millimeter deep socket and 2-inch extension. I will remove this axle nut. Just gonna remove this metal clip. And right now I'm going to use a 32 axle nut socket. To loosen it up, this pinch bolt on a lower control arm, I'm using from this side 19 millimeter deep socket and 18 millimeter wrench. And after, again, I'm gonna spray this area as well as ball joint area with penetrating oil. Right now I will start removing wheel bearings hub. It's for mounting bolts, but before I will just spray this section with penetrating fluid so that hopefully it would come out quickly. And to remove this mount bolts I'm gonna use 17 millimeter deep socket. Wasn't get chance to remove one bolt, so I will that lower one I wasn't be able to reach it, so at this moment I put jack underneath of a knuckle and right to support it, to support weight, and now I'm gonna remove this upper ball joint mount. I'm going to use deep 22 millimeter socket. Right now I'm taking whole assembly with my two hands, and I will remove it from lower ball joint. And right now I will remove this force piece for mounting bolt. And what I'm gonna do now, again, I'm just gonna use penetrating oil on this section. And now I'm going to use hammer, and I will try to take it off. Yeah, and it's what I'm going to do now. I'm going to use a drill and I'm gonna sand it, all of the sensors. I'm gonna try to remove rust from it. I'm going to clean a knuckle, so I'm using this type of inserts and just a drill, so I'm going to clean it up. On my next move, I'm going to remove this lower control arm nuts. I'm gonna remove it from both sides, so that it would be less tension. And to do it, I'm going to use 19mm from nut side and 22mm wrench I'm going to use from bolt side. And same for another side. On my next move, I'm going to push this lower control arm all the way down, and for this purpose I'm gonna use just a ratchet with extension bar, and I will try to move it down. So from this moment I'm going to cut these two bolts I'm going to cut, and before doing it I wrap it up front axle and the inner tie rod. I just secure them, put it upper so that they would not gonna be on the way. Before starting cut, I would recommend to remove this rubber bushing just with a sharp knife. So you're just gonna cut it. I'm gonna try to cut part of it. And after, what's also important to use your cutting blade closer to arm frame. So usually, if I'm gonna cut it, I'm gonna try to be as closer to this arm as possible. I'm not gonna go against vehicle frame, because with saw you can damage this area as well as this area. So I always gonna try to cut as closer as possible. Same for this side. Same for this side. I going to cut right in the edge. I'm not gonna cut in this closer to frame. I gonna be trying to touch this area and this area. At first, I'm going to cut this nut section of a bolt, and after I'm going to cut this bolt side. And between each cut, every 1 minute I'm going to use WD-40 to spray it, the sides for helping for a saw cuts. And what is good is that, for example, if you're just gonna cut this first side off for a nut side, this side with a bolt, you can try to cut it not all the way down, but to keep maybe 3/16, quarter of an inch size, and after just to try to twist it. So it's might gonna help. And again, this breaker, this extension pipe, I'm gonna try to twist it. Now it's still solid, so I'm gonna cut. I'm gonna keep cutting a bit more. So this piece I cut it, and it's I left about 1/8 size, which I haven't touched with the saw, and after I twisted in a previous video, and it's get loosened. It's get broken. It just tension drop on the camera, so it's wasn't be able to capture this moment. But in this way, if you're gonna cut first nut side off, after it's gonna be easier because you have grip with a bolt side, so that you can broke that extra 1/8 length with breaker bar or with ratchet. So same would happen on this side. First I'm gonna cut this side, and only after I'm gonna cut bolt side. I already started cutting this nut side, but what I did, I use from one side, I use a jack to lift that side in a previous place so that it would not make a move. And what I'm also going to do, this side I'm not gonna cut completely. I'm gonna keep some 1/8 of an inch of metal so that when I'm gonna start cutting this side, it's not gonna move in any direction because of vibration. So I'm gonna keep tiny bit of metal in this bolt, and after I just gonna hammer it out with a hammer. I just gonna punch it out. I will lose this upper control arm bolt. I'm gonna start from left side, so I have 19 mm ratchet on this side with extension pipe, and a 19 mm wrench on another end. Try to hammer it out, this mount bolt. This one is good because of this drive shaft. I don't have enough room to take that bolt out, so I'm gonna cut it. This one, it's not enough clearance for this bolt, so I'm gonna start. I'm gonna loosen up this nut, and after I'm gonna lift it all the way up, and after I'm gonna cut. To loosen it up, this nut, I was using 19 millimeters on one side. I used 19 millimeter on one side wrench, and after this bigger size of and after this bigger size of wrench, I make this attachments, and I make it loose. I make loose this nut, and now upper controller moving freely. So right now I will hold it. I will try to keep it in this place, and after I'm gonna start cutting this side. Okay, so I just cut it off this last bolt. I use this wire block in one side, and I cover it up. Caliper with paper towels from any fallen debris, and now it's just gonna be removed. Okay. So this is second end, and this is control arm. So it's removed. And the good side that this end, it has a deep groove, so it's actually possible to go deep with the blade. Important when you're cutting not to ruin these surfaces, not to cut it, because it's possible that it's gonna happen, so always better to be careful.